says Riptoes. I think we go Riptoes. I think we go Riptoes Rage, and then if we beat Riptoes Rage, then we... Oh, gosh. Oh, we're getting right into it. We're getting right into it. Sunny Shore. Scepter. It's Gulp, Crush, and Ripto. That's appropriately named. Gulp, who eats everything. Crush, who smashes everything. And Ripto, who's just Ripto. As possible, as many of the gems. I would like to 100% this entire game, honestly. Get all the gems, all the orbs, all the talismans, everything there is to get. So if you want me to do that, let me know in the comments, because I would love to do that. I've been like wanting to 100% a game for a long time, and I feel like Spyro is like the perfect level of like, the perfect level of just like relaxing nostalgic content that I would really enjoy. I remember all of this perfect. Like, I played this level so many times. It's insane. We're not gonna be able to get all the gems right off the bat, because there's like certain stuff that you like can't get without having certain powers. This trilogy a few months back was a great time to relive the childhood. I played this game so much. Zoe, get out of the way. Okay, I know. Thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you, Zoe. I know. I know. You don't have to tell me. Okay. Nice. Here's these giant chimps over here. Oh, we save this little guy here. See, I can't get up there until I get the climbing powers, which I don't really remember. Oh god, here's money bags. How could I forget money bags? Who's your go-to, Crash or Spyro? Definitely, definitely Spyro. I would, oh. I forgot you can't cram those guys. I would definitely say Spyro. I think Spyro is way more fun than Crash Bandicoot was. Not that Crash Bandicoot was like boring or anything, but it's just very one-dimensional, or two-dimensional rather. Whereas this is way more three-dimensional. What a vibrant. 100 gems to cross the bridge, sure thing. Oh, this animation's probably gonna be really cool. Well, not nearly as cool as I was hoping, but. Oh, come on. I was about to charge right through that guy. Okay. So there's all these like little lanterns up on the ceiling that we have to breathe fire into, I believe. There we go. And just like that, we're done with the level. Twitchy the chimp cutter. He gives us his talisman, but there's more to that than collecting all the talismans. You gotta get a bunch of different things. I forgot to change my title on Kick. That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. Let's see here. Oh, there's a little Boonza, the gym cutter, the little red dragons. Okay, here we go. So now we spit these rocks. There we go. Alright, that's 1 out of 6. Follow me to the next lizard. Oh, come on. Come on. Okay. Okay. Come on. Come on. Here we go. Oh. Okay, wait. Do I have my... No, I don't have the hover ability yet. Come on. Come on. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get this until... jump over there. That's fine. That's fine. Let me fix my stream title real fast, because I forgot to change it. Forgot to change it from, let's see, ASMR Spyro the Dragon. Fantastic. Fantastic. Okay. Also, Godzilla, thank you for the follow on Kick. Easy. Let's follow him. Go classic Spyro on the PS1 was an even bigger classic. Let me tell you. These games are so, like, just nostalgic. The same button as okay, there's five. We got one. Wait, no, that's only four. We got two more. I love how these games are really easy, but like also they added stuff like, you know, the gems and all the orbs and stuff. Like, if you want to truly 100% the game, it's gonna take a lot more time and like a lot more effort, but you can also just play the game, just to play the game, you know. You could just, you know, play the game to beat the story, or you can play the game to 100% everything, and I really enjoy that. Okay, last one here. It's right up there. Boom. 6 out of 6. Okay, so now he gives us an orb as well. And that is two orbs from the first level here. That is two orbs from the first level. And I can go ahead and spit that. Is there any gems back here? Let's see. Guidebook. Let's see the guidebook. 276 gems out of 400. And we're missing one more orb. I think probably what's going to be the better thing to do here. And there's a couple of gems. What's going to be the better thing to do here is to probably just continue on and then come back after we have like our hover power and, you know, all the other powers that you get throughout the game. Oh, here's two more. Perfect. Okay. Perfect. Like up there, we're not going to be able to get up there, but I think we might not need to. Let's see if I can maneuver from this one over here. I remember there was like, you can kind of like fly, you can kind of cheat the system and fly into here, but I don't know if we can get far enough. Also, let's just make sure that we have all the ground gems here. I'm sure there's some gems that we're missing somewhere. Oh, I just realized that we can get this gem right here by just flying into here. There we go. Perfect. Okay, let's fly up here. We got, oh, wow. Let's fly this way. Rotate the camera around. Get this. Nice, it's a 10. Little tenner right there. Let's do fly through here. And let's go up here. Grab that, these two, that one. Oh, there's a lot up here. There's a good bit of gems up here that we, what do we have now? Guidebook, 340 out of 400, so we're missing 60 gems somewhere, and I can almost guarantee you I know exactly where they are. Let's fly through here, let's see if we can get there. See if we can get there. Oh no. Yeah, it's not gonna be possible for us to get over here. But there is a bunch of gems just kinda hanging out over here. Let's go and just progress on. Let's just push forward, alright? Let's just push forward. Treasure found. Spectacular. Fiber, we're gonna be playing Spyro for a couple hours, and then I'll be hopping on Apex for some more non-ASMR. Some kind of goat. Is it? These graphics are incredible. These graphics are actually incredible.
They can be used to defeat Ripto.
Oh, there's Hunter.
Hunter, where have you been?
Oh, I got lost.
Why does Hunter sound like Mirage? Hunter sounds like Mirage. Swim underwater, we have to learn a bunch of different things.
You can keep them in your guidebook.
Hey, I could do that. Why isn't the dragon just torch ripped up?
You can't even keep them in your running shoes. How can we trust you with 14 talismans? If you come across any orbs, but I'll tell you about that.
So, the little sheep, this world, this music, everything about this little area here is so perfect. So perfect. I almost feel like I need to turn up the volume of the game here. Because it is, it's that nice. It's that nice. I wonder if there's an option to do, let's see, sound, music, reignited, dynamic music, volumes, voice lines. Okay, so you can turn down the voice lines while leaving the music up. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. Oh, this is nice. Because, I mean, all the sounds of picking up the gems and everything like that is perfect. Again. Are those the only two? There was another one back here, right? roast marshmallows together at the end. That's right. That's right. They like come to life. I love this. Oh my god, that's so stupid. That's so dumb, but so funny. Okay, Foreman Bob, Spyro. Why is this dude hammering himself in the head? What? What on earth was that? Get out of the way, buddy. Oh my. Okay. Now he's gonna let us into the next area. One, two, three, smash. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay, let's go this way. Other stuff that we can do to get more orbs. Oh, come on. Foreman Max. If you want a permanent job, we've got a place for you here. But for the moment, I want you to have this talisman. Thank you, Foreman Max. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Wow. The way that the portals are built are very, very advanced. Days, they would just like come out of the ground. They would just appear out of the ground, essentially. Okay. Pretty sure this is where. Yep. There's like a little mini game over here, kind of deal. Let's see. Let's see what we can find. Make sure we're getting all the gems. All of the gems. Very important. Nice.